Here is Kruger National Park in South Africa.
Hi, I'm Paul Martin. I'm a filmmaker. This is my first documentary, and it's about the wildlife of South Africa that can be found in Kruger National Park. Enjoy.
There's Africa's wild horse, the zebra. They can't ride them because if they did, their backs would break. And they break very easily. And here we have another herd of zebras. Aren't they beautiful?
Oh, look, there's something ran at them. Is that one of the zebras?
The zebra is running.
Pretty wide, isn't it?
Yeah.
Pretty fat one.
And here is the sable antelope, a very rare antelope. And I'm pretty sure that's a male. This is the kudu. The kudu ball. That's a larger cousin of the nyala. Startled by a bird.
Which way is he walking?
He's
walking
a leopard.
Backwards.
He's running off the road.
Looking.
Isn't he beautiful?
Hello. He's talking about leopards.
Keep the lights on.
We were just talking about these beautiful creatures.
There he is. Isn't he beautiful? He's handsome, isn't he?
Oh.
He's just going for an afternoon stroll.
I'm glad the people in the Far East don't want leopards.
I know.
And he was just lying in the grass, just next to the road.
You did well to spot him.
I think he's enjoying the limelight, isn't he?
Oh, he's loving it.
Yeah.
He doesn't seem to be disturbed by the light, does he?
No.
I think he's a little bit annoyed, but...
What are you eating?
Something.
I'll have to tell my cat about him when you're home.
Now the photo's coming up.
Good.
Baby giraffe foraging the leaves of the redoring tree. Plenty of giraffes here. Cute little baby.
Across the road.
It's if you're unethical. You could just drive straight into its legs.
And you fall on the car and crush us.
Yeah, that's true. Well, we better not do it.
Is that a female, do you reckon, pregnant?
Well, it's a young one.
You can run 30 kilometers an hour.
The scrub here.
And unfortunately he's on every...
They had to graze at night, do they?
They do, yes.
Isn't this dangerous for lions and things?
No, the dangerous would be for...
We have a herd of hippos. Look like they're enjoying the water.
They're swimming over this way. They're standing up. Hello, he's looking at us. Hello.
Yeah, my mom's got all the water here. Oh, okay, cool.
Round hornbill.
Yeah, nice smell to the African bush.
These hornbills.
Don't feed it now.
Edge, if his father was down the road, he'd be here by now.
I reckon his father might have got murdered by the lions.
Here we have a hyena cub, which appears to be...
Don't worry, his father's just down the road, so don't worry.
Here's a hyena.
Oh, right.
Peeking out at us.
There's another one too.
The hyena is a distant relative of the civet and the mongoose, and more distantly related to the cat, not closely related to dogs.
Each fall, the sun will be behind you, there won't be a silhouette.
Great shot, three of them together.
Yeah, I've got all three of them looking at once. Great.
Yeah, the one just standing at the back checking things out. That
one's a juvenile.
These are powerful jaws, aren't they?
Well, there's a fourth one further back.
Yeah, that's right. It's coming down to say hello.
Each forward, Paul.
I'm recording.
Little light.
Light.
And there's breastfeeding going on. Isn't that cute?
Nice fluffy tail.
Here's a hyena.
Here we have a spotted hyena.
Yes.
See, it's been a very good night ride.
And here's the impala.
What's that thing there?
Big black thing over there. Can you see? These are impalas, a whole herd of bachelors hanging out together.
This is chilling.
Yep. Here's a herd of impala, and we're very fortunate to be able to see them in Kruger National Park. Oh, they snort. jackal.
This is a clip springer. See, the clip springer is standing on a rock. These antelope are specialists. Rocky outcrops called koppies in South Africa. They have small hoofs which have very good grip.
Do you mind edging? So you do your video first.
Which way?
Here we have rocky outcrop in Skukuza, Kruger National Park. On top of the rock we have clip springers. You can see the males have horns and the females do not. Clip springers are specialists of rocky outcrops called koppies in South Africa. You can see they have very adept hoofs that can grip very steep surfaces. They're found only in this rocky outcrop territory. Although one wonders how they travel between rocky outcrops to establish new territories.
And here is the Chacma baboon, the biggest primate in southern Africa. Here we have a whole herd of baboons. This one's feeling itchy. Here they are picking ticks out of one another.
See the big one, oh, he's a big male, is he the one just
over? Yeah. Away on the other
side.
Yeah. It's a big race of them.
Yeah, right.
All good? All right.
And here's the buffalo. big mighty beasts that can kill lions and do.
That's the lesser-tailed bush baby.
Wow, good spot,
that's,
Andrew.
That's very good spotting. That's fully grown.
Wow, he's good. There's a, isn't there another bush baby that's a bit bigger, isn't
there? Gone down a bit. He's gone down the branch.
Oh, I see him again.
They make good pets, don't they?
I'd love to have one.
Yeah, he just ran down.
Whoa, there he is.
They jumped off.
Whoa, look at that, jumps.
Where's he gone?
He's on this thorn bush, Andrew.
Oh, yeah, there he is. Yeah, tiny. I didn't remember them being so small.
That's fully grown.
Oh, that's a good, you got a good shot there.
I got him.
Yeah, he's give another shot off, maybe.
Let's not blind him anyway.
One more do.
Just a little thing.
Look at those handsome looking does. Yeah.
Here's some antelope at the river at Skukuza. And here we have the bushbuck right up close to our accommodation. And here's another one. Two females. They're rather skittish. And having a drink. Why not? It's a hot day. Here is the bustard. And here is a civet.
Yeah, it's definitely a civet. But it's deep in the bush. Well, it's probably
but it was right next to the road.
No, it's late.
No, it's
yeah, set it right down there.
Get the eyes on it,
Luke. Here's some crocodiles at Parfuri, far north of Kruger.
Couple swimming down.
There's an enormous one over there with just the top of its head.
Yeah.
Just its eyes above the water.
See this one, a huge one in the water?
Yeah.
That's about 4 meters long.
There's another big one over there,
and
that thing there.
Look at the mouse on
them.
Yeah. You wouldn't want to roll in here accidentally, would you?
Oh, you probably wouldn't want to do that, no. Well, he's going in the water now.
Checking
and that one's going in the water over there. See that one there? It's going in.
You can also see the fish eggs will come down and make scat. Look at the fish here, over there.
What are the cars driving behind them for? Just waiting.
Okay. These are African wild dogs. The large predator.
Okay. Wow. Do we reverse?
No, just stay where you are.
Oh, they got collars on some of them.
Yes.
Look at their jaws. Oh, he's eating something. This one's eating something. It's everything. Oh, look, the eagle just, or whatever it is.
Vulture.
Vulture.
And these are vultures following the pack around, hoping, I guess, to cash in on the kill.
It's a beer to the left, right?
They're like mischievous juveniles, yeah. Listen to them.
Yes.
You're a good boy. Hello. Hello. You've got a few teeth missing on the right-hand side, this one.
Yes.
The whole side of his teeth missing. Check him out, see?
Yep.
See all the teeth.
He does too. True one with the whole pack. Here we can see the pack interacting with each other. The puppies can be quite vicious. They can even bite holes in one another's ears. They're quite a resilient little creature. And in Kruger National Park a few years ago, there was about 300 of them. Now there's less than 100 in the park, and here we've seen maybe up to a third of the wild dogs in the entire park. Pretty amazing. And like baboons, they seem good at preening one another.
Spotting the snake eagle though earlier.
This is a view from the rest camp, Lataba. Very nice view. Here's the squirrel. This is a steenbok, a male and female, small antelope, and they're not very common. This is the marabou stork. More marabou stalks.
They look a bit evil up there, don't they?
Darwin, Steve, Kakadu.
It's like a big tortoise or turtle. See? Just going down.
Here's the vulture, one of the noblest animals in Africa, since they clean up carrion. And isn't it beautiful?
Side.
sitting atop of a high tree like a mighty king of the African land. Here we have vultures enjoying a kill. It's a dead baby buffalo, and they're having a good fight over it. When you have several different species of vultures, they are going to fight over it.
Sticks his head right inside it.
So you can see most of them have got a black face, but you can see at the back there there's one with a pink face and a white head.
Yeah.
That's a white-headed vulture. They're quite uncommon. And the right, the far right, there's a leopard-faced vulture. That's the one with the pink head.
Yeah.
They're standing over it and trying to mantle around it.
Yeah.
When they spread their wings.
Yeah.
Trying to say, it's fine.
Here's a couple more flying in. Cruising in like a jumbo jets.
Just cruising in like a vulture.
Oh, that's a big one.
Yeah.
And a different species.
It's a leopard face. It's the big
one. We could see a real fight here.
Oh.
You see the size differential between the leopard face.
Yes.
I don't know if I should say this.
Don't. The leopard faces come in. They're the dominant vultures.
Wow, look at that. Leopard-faced vulture is driving the other
leopard
species
out. Leopard-faced is quite uncommon actually, they're not, they're the rarer.
They're bigger than the others, aren't they? That's why they intimidate them.
Yeah.
Yep. It's the law of the jungle.
There are cape vultures here as well.
They clean up the rubbish.
Do you see them, Steve?
Yeah, very well. Yeah.
Notice how they tolerate their own kind. There's two leopard faces and they're both tolerating each other, but they're not tolerating the other species that try and come and steal from them.
Yeah. Oh, that would better go each other then.
Wobbly.
Yeah,
saw me. Here's a jackal coming in to challenge the vultures.
So we see the hierarchy of who beats who between the leopard-faced vulture, which clearly beats all the other vultures.
They both like carrion.
This is a black-backed jackal, more common variety. The other is the...
Is it a full adult or is it a young one?
It's a full adult. They're not very big. So they're mostly scavengers, or they feed on insects.
Attacking.
No. Very easily scared.
He's had a couple of mouthfuls and then he... See how he bared his teeth at them?
Yes.
He must have been very hungry.
Yeah. On the carcass.
Yep.
Because you can see so many different types of vultures.
Do you think the other ones have eaten already, or they're just waiting their turn?
Yeah, some of them.
Now he's cracked the shits now.
And here we have a whole herd of vultures. These are warthogs. And here's an impala with a whole herd of waterbuck. And here's a male and female being very affectionate towards each other.
Got a picture of the lovebirds though.
Yeah.
Here's a zebra, and in the background are two water bucks, male and female.
This is a herd of wildebeest, blue wildebeest. Look rather superficially similar to buffalo. No common ancestry of the buffalo. Calves are much lighter than the adults. It's going to be seen by this calf over here, coming up close to its mother. Calves suffer a high mortality rate to predators, although the herd will usually try to protect them from cheetahs, lions and leopards.
Here are some wildebeest calves. Aren't they cute? And their meat is delicious. Well, and we're just outside the Tara campsite. Young wildebeest enjoying a succulent meal of grass.
Oh, but
here's a woodpecker. Here's the duiker.
Yeah, that's the
common
duiker, also known as the grey duiker.
Yeah. Yeah.
This little creature sometimes, doesn't happen often, but sometimes both males and females can both have horns.
Take the light off his eyes, Ange.
Yeah, no, these are just... You can tell the difference between the grey...
Oh, aren't they?
Here's my ass.
Yeah, they seem to be very skittish, yeah. These ones, don't
they?
They
are. They're...
This is the brown snake eagle. And here's an eagle. This is a young battle ear eagle.
A young battle ear is directly above you, please.
What's that?
Yeah, battle ear, young one.
Is that a ton of eagle? Or?
Yeah.
Pretty surfeited.
Thank you.
There's the fish eagle eating its prey. There's a vulture's suit.
Here we have an African fish eagle. It's a juvenile one.
Here's some eagles eating a kill. Two of them have flown off, but this one is hungry.
Let's see.
Look.
Sorry.
Good footage. See?
Scared it off for us.
Yeah, but we got footage of it flying, didn't we? Look at that. This is the fish eagle. And this is the early morning call they make. And here's the fish eagles feeding in a drying up riverbed. Their natural environment is water.
The other one wants to steal.
Bit of action.
Nice big wings.
See how they took turns? The other one chased the first one off.
Here's an elephant, a massive bull elephant. Here's the lion holding up traffic. Isn't he adorable? And here's a pride of lions having a nice relaxation and recuperation. The whole herd is still asleep. Here we have lions asleep at night.
It's also blowing the cover too, because other animals looking for distance.
And there's bats flying around near the lions. This is called the what?
The
Lekavan. That's a lizard. This is the millipede.
What are they? Lizards and all that sort of stuff, are they?
There's the monkey with a baby, having a good feed off the fever tree.
Little baby one. See the baby one just down the...
Yeah, I'm filming it.
The male and Yala. As we can see, a close cousin of the bushbuck.
And here's the Nyala again. Very beautiful and majestic. They've been known to kill humans before. And there's the females. And here's Africa's biggest bird, the ostrich. Can kill with a single kick. A distant cousin of the emu. Here we see the white rhinoceros, very rare and endangered. Here's the white rhinoceros, very rare animal in the wild and greatly endangered.
These are white milk sharks, these ones.
Triton 19.
In what period?
Since they've been together, it doesn't, I don't know.
These are two dogs, are they?
I hope you enjoyed that documentary. If you want to do more to help the animals of South Africa, then I suggest you book a ticket to South Africa and spend some time and some money in Kruger National Park. because that will help the animals. Take care. Thank you.